Recently, Anker held a special event and announced its best multi-device fast charging lineup, GAM Prime. And today we got the brand new GAM Prime 120W charger, also called 737 charger. It adopts Verve's first HFB topology developed by Anker and Infineon and supports dynamic power distribution. So let's take it apart and see what's inside. This time, Anker changes packaging from white to black and the GAM Prime and charger are in the middle. The backside is printed with some features of GAM Prime. The input-output and some certifications are printed on the side. Open the box, it contains the charger and manual. And this time, Anker uses a rubber pad with suction cups to fix the charger. Tear off the plastic film. And then remove the protective sticker from the top metal panel. The Anker and GAM Prime are printed on the side. The input prongs can be folded. Pretty convenient. And then let's see the spec info. Model is A2148. It can support up to 120W and has passed different certifications. It also supports input of 100-240V, 50-60Hz, 1.9A, and 3 different output strategies. You can pause to take a look. 2 USB-C and a USB-A ports are at the top. The size of the charger is about 80x32x43mm, so the power density is 1.08W³/cm. Compared with Apple 96W charger, you can see the size difference. And the weight is about 195 grams. ChargeLab Power ZKM002C shows the USB-C one supports FCP, SCP, AFC, QC3.0+, QC4+, PD3.0, and PPS protocols. And it also has 4 fixed PDOs of 5V, 3A, 9V, 3A, 15V, 3A, 20V, 5A, and a set of PPS. The USB-C 2 is exactly the same as that of the USB-C 1, so the performance of those two ports is the same. And then the USB-A supports FCP, SCP, AFC, and QC3+ fast charging protocols. And then let's take it apart to check the internal components and architecture. Start from the input prongs. We can use the spudger to pry along the gap, and there are lots of pink silicon adhesives inside. We can't just to pull it out and have to use the cutting machine to destroy the plastic case. And after taking apart, we found the entire charger is filled with pink silicon adhesives, which is quite common in Anker chargers. A copper foil with heat-resistant tape is pasted inside the plastic case for heat dissipation and insulation. Next, we have to clean it up. It really takes a lot of time, so let's speed up. This charger is composed of multiple PCBs and adopts planar transformer, which can improve space utilization. The black and red wires are connected to the input PCB. Here is the primary circuit, and the secondary circuit is on the other side. And here are two USB-C and a USB-A port. ChargeLab found it adopts the hybrid flyback architecture plus PFC circuit. Next, let's introduce all components one by one. The time delay fuse is from Better Electronics, 5A, 250V. The safety X2 capacitor is next to it and from DGCX, 0.47 μF. Two common mode chokes are also on this small input PCB. Two bridge rectifiers are on the front and back of the PCB, which can convert AC into pulsed DC and evenly dissipate it. Two film capacitors are from DGCX, which can filter out pulsed DC. 1 μF, 450V. The PFC controller is from ON Semiconductor NCP1623, featuring in valley synchronous frequency foldback, The GaN-IC for PFC Boost is also from Navitas NV6136A, which adopts QFN 6x8 package. It integrates driver and current sampling circuit, 170 milliohm 700 volts. And the PFC Boost inductor is wrapped with tape for insulation. The PFC Boost rectifier is from Pingwei, which is an ultra-fast recovery diode, 5 amp 600 volts.The bypass diode is also from Pingwei, used to protect the PFC circuit. The electrolytic capacitor is from Yongming, 100 microfarad, 420 volts. The primary controller is from Infineon, which adopts PG-DSO-14 package. It is a digital hybrid flyback controller, which integrates a 600 volts high voltage startup circuit and drivers. This GaN-IC is also from Infineon, which integrates two GaN-FETs.Both are 140 microfarad and 600 volts. They can form into half bridge and have independent isolation driver. This tiny filter capacitor that powers the primary controller is also from Yongming, 47 microfarad, 35 volts. This resonant capacitor is connected in series with the primary side of transformer, 0.56 microfarad, 250 volts. The blue safety X capacitor is in here,And the EL1018 optocoupler is used to regulate the output voltage. The synchronous rectifier controller is from MPS, marked with IBUJN. The synchronous rectifier is from Infineon, 100 volts, 3.4 milliohm. Here is the planar transformer. A Yongming solid capacitor is soldered next to planar transformer, 470 microfarad, 25 volts. Here is the secondary buck PCB.Several small PCBs are vertically soldered on this main PCB. An EL1018 optocoupler is located outside the small PCB to control the PFC circuit. SMDY capacitor is from Anshan KFET. Two protocol chips are from iSmartware SW3536, corresponding to two independent buck circuits. Two MOSFETs used for buck circuits are from Infineon, 40 volts, 1.8 milliohm.The other two buck MOSFETs are also from Infineon, 40 volts, 6.3 milliohm. Both alloy buck inductors are 4.7 microhenry. Two filter capacitors for buck circuits are from Yongming, 470 microfarad, 25 volts. Here is the VBUS MOSFET for the USB-C1 from Infineon, and those two VBUS MOSFETs for USB-A and USB-C2 are also from Infineon.The current sense amplifier is from SG Micro, used for output current sampling. The black thermistor is used to detect the temperature inside the charger. The other thermistor is the same. The MCU is from ASSOFT, which is a 32-bit high-performance MCU with an M0 core. It adopts QFN32 package and is used for internal temperature detection and protection.Two USB-C sockets are insulated with heat-resistant tape and fixed with glue.The USB-A is blue and its internal pins are customized for higher currents. Well, that's all components of the Anker GaN Prime 120W charger. It adopts the world's first HFB architecture developed by Anker and Infineon. After taking apart, we found it has two output circuits responsible for USB-C1 and USB-C2 USB-A respectively.It also monitors the power needs of connected devices in real time and intelligently distributes power accordingly. Okay, that's all for today's video. If you like this video, please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!